The 87-year-old leader of the Dionysiou Monastery, Abbot Gabriel, offers a modern interpretation of the famous Apocalypse fresco.
It is that I saw locusts flying in the sky. This symbolized today's airplanes, and the locusts were like horses arrayed for battle, and they had the power of hurting men for 5 months. And then I saw a star fallen from heaven to earth, and a bottomless pit was formed, and from the shaft of the pit rose smoke like the smoke of a great furnace, and 1/3 of the mankind was killed by the fire and smoke, and those who survived were disfigured.
A monk spends his life preparing for death and the uniting of his soul with God. On Athos, burial is brief. After a few years of interment, the remains are moved to a small crypt which houses the bones of all monks who served at Dionysiou. Each monk's name and the date of his death is inscribed on his skull. Another relic, a section of links used by the Romans when they imprisoned Saint Peter the Apostle in chains. Father John, the gatekeeper, explains to us why he became one of the monks of Mount Athos.
I'll speak as plainly as I can, so you will understand my reason for leaving America. I never thought of coming to Greece. It never entered my mind. Come to Parakalo. It never entered my mind to come to Greece. It was because my adopted country gives me the right, under the Constitution, to follow the faith of my religion to the best of my knowledge and understanding, and that is why I came to Greece. Now, it all happened in this manner. I lived a good life in America, a full of life, so I never had much time to think about God, although my mother taught me when I was little the meaning of the word God. So finally I got sick, and I began to think of what I did, if I did anything for my soul, for the benefit of my soul, which I never did anything. Of course, I went to church once in a while, but that was more of a form than of faith. So as I lay sick in my bed, I made up my mind that from here on, I would do as much for my soul as I did to benefit my body as I lived in America. So I made up my mind, and in a week's time, I was ready. I was on the boat and coming to Greece. I intended to go to Jerusalem, but I was so sick I did not stop to find out where the boat did go. I knew it went to Greece, and that's as far as I wanted to know. It took me 3.5 years to take the vow to become a monk, because I was afraid of the changeover, that I might not be able to live the life as a monk. So I made up my mind. I got used to the ways of the life here in Mount Athos, and it was not so hard because I had made up my mind to do my best to follow the laws of my religion. During those 3.5 years, I lived the life of an ordinary monk. We are awakened at about 1:30 in the morning, and we are given about half to 1 hour of time to read or pray in our cell before we go to church. Nimilate. When you go to church, we have our rosary with us, and we listen to the chanting, we listen to the reading of the Psalms of David, and also we do say silent prayers with our rosary. That takes about 3.5 hours of work of church service in the night. After that, in our monastery, we are giving a break, and we take a short nap for about an hour and a half. And then we come back and go to church for Mass, or liturgy as we call it, which takes about 1.5 hours. After that, if the day is that we should eat, have a meal, after the church service, we go to the refectory and we have our morning meal, which is around 10 o'clock in the morning. After the meal, each one of us goes about his daily work, which is not very hard work, up until in the evening, around 4 o'clock, when Vespers when the office of Vespers will take place. Then we go to church for about 1.5 hours. After that, we eat again for the evening meal. After the evening meal, we have about 1.5 hours to ourselves. We rest and talk if we want to, or take things easy. At sundown, we have the evening prayer, which consists of the salutations of the Holy Mother and a few short prayers. And after that, we ask forgiveness of each other for faults that we did during the day, and we go to our cell. Now, a good monk would read or pray for about an hour and a half after he goes to his cell and takes a short nap. Again, we have to get up at 1:30 and follow the daily routine. Now, the rosary that we have, each monk has a rosary, and we learn the silent prayer, the prayer of Jesus, which is a continuous prayer. Meaning, you don't have to say, Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, help, have mercy on me. That is done orally, mentally, with the sight, with the sound. In fact, to look at God's creation is just like saying a prayer to the Lord. You do respect, appreciate, and worship the Almighty by just being on earth. We pray here for the safety of the world, for the safety of all of us, for the peace of the world, for the unity of the churches, for our well-being, for everybody in particular. Our daily church life is over 8 to 10 hours a day. We have to fight three evils. The first evil is ourselves. The second evil is the world and all its temptations. And the third and worst evil is the devil. And he is a constant enemy. He is the enemy of the human race.